Alright guys, we're back in my garage for another video, and today we're going to be talking about oil again. I have a unique opportunity now because unfortunately I was only able to drive the 440i about 3,000 miles this year. I've been super busy and just had a lot of stuff going on. I work from home a lot as well, so unfortunately I just didn't get to enjoy it that much. But I thought this video would be a good opportunity to talk about how full synthetic oil can perform in a modern engine if you change it at 3,000 miles, which is basically, you know, the recommended oil change interval for cars that run like conventional oils and just older engines. So I know a lot of people feel like that's a really good recommendation and something that you should stick with, even on modern engines with synthetic oils. And I'm going to share the results from my car, so hopefully this answers any questions you might have. Now, for anybody that's new to the channel, I create videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that you have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you are interested in videos like that, be sure to subscribe. There will be a lot more coming out in the future. So I have my oil analysis results here. Again, I went through Blackstone Laboratories. Big shout out to them. They do a lot of really good work for the community. The main thing that they support are cars with like millions of miles, you know, semi-trucks and things like that, where your oil analysis will give you good insight on the health of the engine and hopefully help you get ahead of any problems that could potentially happen. And in my case, it was no different. You know, I care a lot about my car, even though it's not getting that high in mileage. I do want to do an oil analysis so I know that my engine is healthy, my oil change intervals are on time, I'm using the right oil. And basically, it just gives you confirmation that you're on the right track with your maintenance. So I highly, highly recommend it. I'm definitely not an oil report expert. You know, I'm learning as I go. And every time I go through an oil analysis, I learn of something new to pay attention to. But the nice thing with Blackstone Laboratories is they actually have a comment section and they will tell you exactly what you should pay attention to. You know, if there's anything that is questionable or anything that's a concern, and they'll explain what it could potentially be. So I really highly recommend it. And the other nice thing with them is they have a big repository of data for people on different platforms. So not only can they tell you what to pay attention to on your car, but they can also compare your results to other people that have the same mileage, do similar oil change intervals. You know, all of that can just give you a good understanding of the health of your car. So yeah, one more time, I'll say it. Big recommendation for Blackstone Laboratories. Reach out to them. You can get a free oil analysis kit. And then whenever you're ready to actually send your sample in, that's when you pay and they'll send you your results in email. So with the 440i, right now we are running Liqui-Moly 5W30 full synthetic oil. And I'm actually comparing this to my previous oil change where I was using 5W40. I dropped down to 5W30 because it's actually the right BMW spec for our engines. BMW also approves 5W40 for quote unquote top offs. Obviously from my previous oil analysis, it works fine in our engines, but I just wanted to run something thinner that met the LL01 FE spec for the B58. So dropped down to 5W30. Everything seemed pretty good. I didn't have any oil burning or anything. I never had to top off oil. And based on their analysis, they're basically confirming that there's nothing wrong with the engine. At my mileage, the metal wear is low, but they're suspecting that the whole reason it's low is because my oil change interval was so short. So if I had done it at like 5,000 miles or 6,000 miles, it probably would have matched other cars that are at the mileage that my vehicle is. So everything looks good. The viscosities were all in spec. There was no extra fuel in the car, even though I've gone from ethanol back to pump gas, and now I'm back on full E85, and there's still not any excessive oil in my fuel, no antifreeze, no water. The actual rating and spec for the oil is still good as well. So everything just basically looks good. It looks like an oil that was just put into the car. So they recommend that I go ahead and stick with my original oil change interval that I did last time, which was 5,000 miles. That one looked good, and at that time they said I could probably go 6,000 or 7,000 miles. I don't typically drive that much in a year, but we'll see. Maybe if I really get to enjoy the car next year and go on longer road trips, we can see how this oil performs over, you know, 6,000 to 7,000 miles. But yeah, I mean, that's basically my report. People post these a bunch on Facebook, so I'll also link a Facebook group in the description for anybody that's interested in trying to search for more data from other enthusiasts. But yeah, I mean, this was kind of what I expected, and I just wanted to throw my data in the mix so that you guys can see there are cars that have oil that basically looks like new when you pull it out at 3,000 miles and can go much, much longer without any excessive wear, damage, you know, oil contamination, or just the oil breaking down in general. The car is designed to work with this oil, and so naturally it works well even at higher mileage. So yeah, hopefully this answers any questions you guys have. If you're curious about anything else, let me know. I know a lot of people really want me to use 0W20. I might use that in the future as well. I still go through FCP Euro for my oil changes, even with, you know, the whole shift in how they do their lifetime warranties. So I already have 5W40 and 5W30 on my shelf, depending on what car it's going into. So, you know, I might try 0W20 just to say I tried it and get some data on that as well. But for now, I'm probably going to stick with what I have since it's already filling up a whole shelf in my garage. So yeah, again, let me know if you guys have any other questions. Otherwise, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below.